Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I'm rendering exposition of John 6, verse 16 to 21. When it was evening, the brethren and not the once-born disciples of the rabbis, this is a corruption by the Messianic Jews. Remember Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. The arid-spirited sect temple priest. They enter the church of God and they bring in corruptions. So these are the corruption, you know, because they used to have disciples. Disciples do what their teacher tells them to do. Whereas the brethren, we are free men. We are not disciples. We have freedom of will. So not disciple of Jesus went down to the sea, embarked in a boat. Boat is our life. This is the boat, you know, of our life. And with this sea is our journey, upheaval, up and down in the life. So across this sea to reach the other end, which is our destination, to Capernaum. It had already grown dark, and Jesus had not yet come to them, you know. That means, remember Jesus when he was eating at the place of Matthew, some Pharisees, Lucy came, they told them, you know, told his laborers, why don't you wash your hand and say prayer and fasting as the disciples of the rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees do? Then Jesus intervened and told them, so far Christ is in their heart, they don't need to do it. When it is gone, as it is today, then they will just do prayer and fasting as they do it in the churches today. So Jesus had not come into their heart yet. So they were doing this journey of their own without Christ in their boat of life. So in a boat and went across the sea to Capernaum. It had already grown dark and Jesus had not yet come to them. The sea was stirred. This is our journey in this world is, you know, some people hate you, some people love you, upheaval, up and down. Because a strong wind was blowing. When they had rowed about 3 or 4 miles, they saw Jesus walking on the sea and coming near the boat. That means walking over water. Water is this one, natural nature. And he belonged to our supernatural Father. So nature was under his thumb. So that's why he was walking on water and making the dead people alive and the lame walk and all that things. And coming near the boat, they began to be afraid that he may be a ghost, you know. But he said to them, it is I, do not be afraid. That means when you want to have Christ in your heart, then you are not so happy because you are afraid of the people, what people will say, what this man will say, what the bishop will say, this man, he will put me to the cross and kill me. So you are afraid, you know, but now is the time you can't be put on the fire, you know, burning stake. So you know you preach gospel from rooftop. Don't be frightened of anyone. He said, it is I, do not be afraid. So Jesus, when you have Christ in your heart, it gave you assurance that the mighty hand of our Father is over your head. So don't worry. Go on, preach gospel. They wanted to take him into the boat, but the boat immediately arrived at the shore. When you have Christ in your heart, then your life journey in this world becomes shortened and quick. You reach the end or the destination quick. as Lazarus did. Lazarus was friend of Jesus, and on death, you know, he was resurrected by Jesus after 4 days to show everyone what is eternal life in God. And when the temple priest came to see it, that, hey, this man is making alive and giving them eternal life, we will have nobody to give us money. They will all leave us. As shopkeeper, you know, if a supermarket is coming near these shops, they are very much frightened that their livelihood will be gone. So same, the priest was frightened that there won't be any person left under them. They will be all free men. So they wanted to take him into the boat, but the boat immediately arrived at the shore to which they were heading. That means they attained their salvation when Christ came into their heart. So everything has inner meaning. It's, the gospel is written, but there is inner meaning hidden underneath one, which you have to dig it out yourself. Nobody is going to tell you. You have to long for a gospel. When you long for gospel, these things come up for you to be picked up. Otherwise, this is a field in which the treasures are buried under it. And the man who found this field, he went home, sold all his property, possessions, as they did when the first church of God was formed, to buy that field and to plow it. Plow means to preach gospel for others to salvage their life, or for others to have resurrection as Lazarus had. And Lazarus was friend of Jesus. Friend means as good as Jesus. So that's why he had resurrection. That was shown to everyone. But when Jesus himself was resurrected, only those could see him who believed in him. Not everybody. So our Father God blesses you.